bowl games. And what does that mean? Conference championships. That's what that means. And in every sense of the word, we had a bunch of great games today. We had a bunch of great ones. And yesterday as well, of course, because there were games on Friday night. But we had a bunch of things go on. First off, there's not going to be a playoff semifinal at the Rose Bowl. It has been relocated to Arlington for this year. Don't understand why they would use Frisco, but that's okay. That's perfectly fine. We have a game in Arlington instead. You know, the last time the Rose Bowl wasn't in Pasadena was way back when it had to go to up on to North Carolina. So, you know, that was what, way back when, during, you know, the attack on Pearl Harbor and stuff like that. So, really interesting to see. So, we're going to have a semifinal, you know, it's going to be one at the Sugar Bowl, obviously, and now one in Arlington, you know, just a couple days removed from the Cotton Bowl. And I know some teams have technically locked up berths in bowl games, but I mean, we have to really, really see what in the world these games are going to look like tomorrow. Let's just go over everything. First off, let's just get some of the other conference championships out the way first. There is no Sun Belt Championship. That's right. COVID canceled the Sun Belt Championship. It's a tragic fate for Coastal Carolina and Louisiana for that game. But, you know, Coastal Carolina is the Sun Belt champions. There's, I don't know what in the world the conference is saying by stating that, you know, yeah, we're just going to name you and Louisiana co-champs. Coastal Carolina is the champs. Louisiana lost to them, so there's no point in talking about that anymore. MAC championship, very surprising result. Ball State just bullied Buffalo, bullied them. They win the MAC championship. I believe they are going to the Arizona Bowl to take on San Jose State, who is ranked 24th. They beat up on Boise State, pretty much had a 2-touchdown lead over them for most of that game. Very surprising result there. And also on Friday night, UAB, second title in 3 years? Second Conference USA title in 3 years? Marshall has just had a bad couple of weeks because, I mean, they looked rough against Rice, and then they just looked even worse against UAB. I didn't watch this game, so. But Marshall, they had a promising start, and they squandered everything in these last two games. It's rather unfortunate. But now we move on to the Power 5 conferences plus the Pac-12. I'm pretty much not counting the Pac-12 as a Power 5 conference anymore. Let's just be real. They continue to miss the playoff each and every year, and it's just like, man. And no better way to achieve peak Pac-12 comedy than to have Oregon represent the Pac-12 North instead of Washington and beat USC. And USC tried to come back for the fourth time in six games, but that wasn't going to happen forever. Oregon put the clamps on them towards the end of that game, and finally, we can end all talk about USC. And USC has just opted out of a bowl game, so they're not going bowling at all. It looks like Oregon will be the only team that gets to go bowling, pretty much, because I mean, the Pac-12 is just dealing with COVID so horridly, and you know, it's just rough to see the Pac-12 look like this. And it's another year of the Pac-12 not going to the playoff. This is what, the fifth year that they haven't been able to go, and they just started way too late. You know, USC and Oregon, both of them had promise, but now both these teams, you can just completely forget about them. Oregon, I'll have to pay attention to, though, in the Fiesta Bowl against whoever they face. But now we move on to Saturday, and Saturday presented us, you know, to today, technically, you know, or, you know, it may be late now wherever you are, midnight, so it's technically a new day wherever you are on the East Coast. But Saturday, championship Saturday, And there were some games involving some other teams on Championship Saturday as well. You know, the Pac-12 placement games. There were some Big Ten games that got scheduled. You know, the second place in the East versus the second place in the West, and yada, yada, yada. But most of those didn't even get played, so who cares? And again, the Pac-12 played some games as well today. But again, who cares? Nobody in this conference did anything worthwhile. And the only team they really had just got beat in the championship game. So, But Texas A&M, Tennessee, let's just talk about that first. A&M as a really, really dominant, you know, really, really damn good, you know, offense. Very balanced, very fun to watch. And, you know, Kellen Mond has grown into his own, but now there's really only one thing remaining, one thing that has to, you know, there's only one question. Is A&M's resume worthy enough to get into the playoff? Because, I mean, they manhandled a bad Tennessee team, and most of their schedule really isn't that good. Honestly, most of the teams in the SEC aren't that good. Let's just get that out the window right now. So the fact that we could say, oh, well, a group of five teams, you know, they don't have the strength of schedule, stop all that. We can stop all that nonsense right now. Because most of the SEC wasn't that good this year. I'm just going to be real with you. They weren't. The Big 12 was terrible. Pac-12 is the Pac-12. The Big 10, rough. ACC, always Clemson. It's been Clemson and Oklahoma winning, you know, the ACC and the Big 12 respectively for the past 6 years. And let's talk about Oklahoma. Iowa State had a perfect opportunity to win a conference championship and, finally win their first conference championship in 100 years. They had it. They had the defense to do it. They had Breece Hall to do it. They had Brock Purdy playing well to do it, but that didn't happen. Oklahoma put the clamps on them, put the defense on its back. It used to be Oklahoma's offense had to save the day, but now it's the defense that saved the day. Six straight championships for the Sooners, and I hate it so much. As a Texas fan, I hate it so much. I honestly do. Big Ten championship. Northwestern, Ohio State. We all know the Big Ten changed the rules to allow Ohio State to get to the championship game. We all know that. We all know it was terrible. But Ohio State, you know, they looked rough once again. Last game they looked rough was against Indiana. That was a rough game. They looked real, real bad here. Is this team worthy of being, you know, a top four team? Well, they're undefeated. They beat Northwestern. It took them about three and a half quarters to get going. So, you know, but they only beat Northwestern by 12. So, I mean, double-digit win. You know, Trace Sermon went for 331 yards on the ground. That's a new record, I think, you know. And, you know, Justin Fields just didn't play well. Only had, 114 yards passing? Not going to get it done in the playoffs. Not going to get it done. Let me tell you that right now. Yeah. It's Texas A&M. It's Ohio State. Do those two teams deserve a playoff spot? Do they have what it takes to play against Clemson or Alabama? Because Clemson blew the brakes off of Notre Dame. We're talking just beat them up. And, you know, a lot of people were saying, you know, oh, well, this would have been the result of the first matchup. We're not talking about woulda, coulda, shoulda. What happened is what happened in that first matchup without Trevor Lawrence. The fact that Trevor Lawrence is there and they blew out Notre Dame like that gives a lot of compensation. There's a lot of things that need to happen. There's a lot of things that need to be said, you know. Notre Dame blew it again in a big-time game. They blew it again. And now the argument is what does Notre Dame do? You know, what can they do to get in? I mean, yeah, they beat Clemson earlier in the season, but I mean, the committee is supposed to take in, you know, stuff like injuries or suspensions and stuff like that. They're supposed to take that stuff into account, along with conference championships, you know, as well, and other stuff, you know, as a part of their criteria. Does Notre Dame have enough aside from their one win against Clemson? You know, and their win against North Carolina too, but that really isn't very valuable because North Carolina has three losses. And Texas A&M's, you know, one big win was Florida, but that doesn't matter now either. So what does Notre Dame do? So what are we gonna do about? You know, we have Ohio State that's gonna probably be number three. They're probably going to be number three, maybe number four. Who knows? But who is going to be the fourth team? Is it gonna be Notre Dame? Do you want to see Notre Dame? Do you want to see Texas A&M, or do you want to see Cincinnati, who has grinded it out? They grinded out a victory against Tulsa. Tulsa's a very tough team anyway, and it really just shows how behind the Big 12 really was this year as far as being, you know, one of the best conferences in the country. I honestly think the American is a power conference at this point. I mean, they're always putting teams in the New Year's Six. They've had undefeated teams in the past, and it's a power conference, basically. Just give them a automatic seat at the table. It's about time. It is about time to give them a seat at the table. And again, Tulsa played tough. They were down, you know, 10 points to Cincinnati again. And, you know, they just got it together. You know, maybe it was a little bit too late. Maybe it was a little bit too early. But I mean, Cincinnati was given the fight of their lives. And somehow, subway, you know, throughout all the missed kicks, throughout all the troubles of getting, you know, getting stuff going, Cincinnati was able to win this game. So there's that. Cincinnati's 9-0. They could be headed to the Peach Bowl, which is rather unfortunate. The argument remains, who is going to be number four? Is it going to be A&M? Is it going to be Notre Dame? Is it going to be Cincinnati? It has to be one of those three, and I think it should be Cincinnati, but my gut is telling me they'll stay with Notre Dame, although they could go with Texas A&M. I really don't know who's going to be the number four team. I really don't. There is a lot the committee has to discuss tonight, so we'll see what they do in the morning. We're only about 12 hours or so, but last but not least, of course, the SEC Championship. And what a game it was. Came down in the final seconds. Kyle Trask went off. Devontae Smith went off. Mac Jones went off. We're talking 5 touchdowns for Mac Jones, 2 touchdowns for Devontae Smith, and 5 touchdowns for Najee Harris. 2 on the ground, 3 receiving. So, in a 52-46 game, you know, where it felt like, you know, Alabama had imposed their will on Florida. But it ended up, you know, becoming a lot closer than you think, you know. It became a lot closer than you think very, very quickly. But in the end, Alabama gets the win. They sack Kyle Trask to end the game. And one of my other questions now that we have, you know, everything sorted out and stuff like that, who's going to win the Heisman? Could it be Kyle Trask? He's grown. He's looked like the best player throughout the season. Could it be Najee Harris? He has really entered the conversation. It's like Derrick Henry a couple of years ago. Derrick Henry entered the conversation for the Heisman very late in the season. Like, I was not expecting this. And just ran away with it. Could it be Devontae Smith? He's having a Charles Woodson-like season. Could it be Mac Jones? I don't know. I don't think so. I know people were throwing out Trevor Lawrence and Justin Fields, but I don't think they have enough there to really say anything about Heisman, you know, anything. But there's that. That's one of my other questions. You know, as we head into Selection Sunday, you know, in a few hours. So again, who's going to be number four? I don't know. Again, my gut's telling me that it would be Notre Dame. It could be A&M. It could be Cincinnati. I really don't know. If the Peach Bowl is where Cincinnati ends up, that's going to be really, really disappointing. You know, as a Texas fan, the story goes like this. 12 years ago, we were undefeated. 1 second left, the against Nebraska in the Big 12 championship game, or rather it was 11 years ago. We got a second put back on the clock. We probably shouldn't have won that game. And, you know, Brian Kelly, you know, he would have had his chance against Alabama that first time all the way back in 2009. But it just didn't happen back then, and we all know the results. But I told y'all this last week, so, you know. So seeing Cincinnati get hosed by the committee again, you know, it's really disheartening. But again, does Texas A&M have enough there? Their best win is a 3-loss Florida team. And, you know, in one of their losses, they just did not look good, and that was that LSU game. It was a bad loss for Florida. Where do the New Year's Six bowls go? Where do we head from there, you know, as far as the New Year's Six games go? Again, I think, you know, the playoffs could be set with Notre Dame, Bama, Clemson, and Ohio State. Or the committee could actually, you know, have some decency, have some balls, and put in either A&M or Cincinnati. They could grow a pair and put either one of those two teams in, and I'd be fine with that. Or not. I mean, again, I don't know. I don't know how the New Year's Six is going to shake up. They're going to take all day to do the New Year's Six bowls for some reason. Really, this should only be an hour, you know, at most. We don't have to drag this out for 4 hours. But this is ESPN we're talking about here, so the whole selection show is going to be dragged out for 4 hours for no reason whatsoever. And a lot of bowl games are starting to get canceled already. So I don't know how that's going to go. There's some that are set already, you know, like the Idaho Potato Bowl, the New Orleans Bowl, the Boca Raton Bowl, you know, Mexico Bowl. I don't know who's going to play Army in the Independence Bowl. I don't know who's going to play UTSA in the First Responder Bowl, because UTSA was supposed to play SMU in the Frisco Bowl, but that didn't happen because SMU, you know, couldn't pass COVID. But New Year's is going to look very fun. I'm anxious to see where Iowa ends up because they looked good this year in LA. They were one of the only teams to play all their Big Ten games that were scheduled, you know, aside from that last week game. My bad, something else there. Aside from that last week game that, you know, wherever they were, where whoever was second place in the, I think they were supposed to play, like, I don't know who they were supposed to play. It doesn't even matter because those games didn't matter at all, and Iowa didn't even play anyway, so, yeah. So, we'll find out in about 12 hours or so who's going to the college football playoff, who's going to the Peach Bowl, who's going to the Cotton Bowl, you know, and the other big bowl games, you know, aside from the Rose and the Sugar. We'll find out who's going to the Outback Bowl. We'll find out who's going to the Gator Bowl. We'll find out who's going to the Citrus Bowl. I mean, you know, it's going to be fun. It's going to be fun. The Fiesta Bowl, of course. What else am I missing? Oh, yeah, the Orange Bowl. Yeah. What about the Orange Bowl? The Peach Bowl, Orange Bowl, Cotton Bowl, Fiesta Bowl. Of course, the Rose and the Sugar. The Rose being relocated from, you know, Pasadena to Arlington this year. So we'll find out what's going there. And, of course, the other, you know, big ones. Again, the Citrus, the Outback, and the Gator Bowl. Find out who's going to those games. So, with that being said, everybody, I'll see you in about maybe, I don't know, about 13 hours to talk about, you know, who's going to the college football playoff. See you then.